I'm Kristen Gatesman. Thanks for joining us for this edition of the show. Today, we're going to take you to Main Street in North Myrtle Beach, where our middle school students are helping some coastal Carolina grad students make our oceans a healthier place for marine life and also for us. And we'll take you to our annual Summer Scholars Program to check out two new classes offered this year that take robotics and Rubik's Cubes to another level. That's right now as we take you inside Horry County Schools. You see them on every street, but probably don't pay much attention. These are storm drains, and they're more important than you think.
Do we have any strong odors coming from it?
I don't smell anything.
You guys? So today we have North Myrtle Beach Middle School, and it's the Conservation Club. And they're coming around with us on Main Street and maybe one or two drains on Pine Street. And we're going to be assessing the drains and assessing the conditions and marking them today.
I wanted to come out here to mark the storm drains and make sure that people don't throw trash in them.
To help people not litter inside the storm drains and the ocean from getting polluted.
And it's a great hands-on learning experience for all of us.
We always need more hands on deck helping out, and the point of our internship is to educate people, and so not only are we educating all these students, but they're educating the public as well.
A lot of our students continue to learn outside of their regular school day, like these middle school students who chose to attend our Horry County Schools Summer Scholars Program.
This is actually coding robots,
okay.
But it can also include programming.
Okay.
But like these little things, they sense like colors. They only sense blue, red, green, and black. And these little codes right here, they give them directions.
So these are our Ozobots. Can I see your Ozobot?
Mm-hmm.
And they're just like little robots, and they have sensors at the bottom that read color. So basically now what they're on the playground apps.
Okay.
And what they're doing is they're trying to produce a start and finish for their Ozobot to start at, put in codes, and then put it in to where it can actually celebrate to make there. And actually, we just finished talking about probability, so they need 100% accuracy to get from start to finish.
Classes like this that work with robotics are meant to teach skills that students can use when the school year begins.
One day I want to go to a really special school that can contain robotics, and I can actually do all that stuff and make my own robot.
This is another new Summer Scholars course that's a lot more than what it seems.
I make sure that all of our students get through a solve on the first day so that they understand it's not impossible and that it's okay to solve a problem with help. They have written instructions, they have my verbal instructions, and they have trial and error. And so absolutely everybody gets through a solve in under 4 hours on the first day.
And if you're a student like Cody who's mastered these Rubik's Cubes, the class offers something a little more challenging.
This is a 7x7. It's not fully scrambled right now, but I can solve it. It takes a really long time, but it's pretty fun. I'm working on speed solving, so I'm learning new algorithms and a lot more intuitive things about the Rubik's Cube. So I've solved it in under 20 seconds about 10 times.
But there's another challenge to this Rubik's Cube class.
First, we're trying to learn how to do a Rubik's Cube, which we've all done. And then now we're doing mosaics, where we use the Rubik's Cubes to make pictures like this, or we can make people.
And of course, we do the mosaics because there's a lot of potential artistry involved, and thinking about resolution and pixels and how we create images digitally. This is essentially pixels, so it helps them think about how a digital image is created, and we get to talk about resolution in the real world, and because it works the same way in the digital world.
And even though each Summer Scholars class is academically centered, the reason these kids choose to spend their summer break in a classroom is simple.
It's really fun.
And parents, believe it or not, we're more than halfway through summer break, so now is the time to prepare for the new school year. If your child is a first-time student in Horry County Schools, please contact the school. They will attend to find out dates and times that you can actually visit the school and register your child in person. We also have online registration for returning students. And check out our classroom supply lists. All of this information can be found, of course, at horrycountyschools.net. And, of course, come with us next time we take you inside Horry County Schools.